pick your own superlatives for the week. Remarkable, incredible, maybe. How about gobsmacking? Fridays in D.C., well, it's usually something we call Firing Friday, but I'd like to christen this Friday Lyin Friday, as in lying, Lyin Friday. Ted Cruz, I hope you don't mind that we borrow your Trump-given nickname. First thing this morning, President Trump walked across the North Lawn of the White House to speak to his good friends at Fox News. So let's start with the Justice Department's blockbuster internal watchdog review. Here's the president's takeaway.
I think that the report yesterday, maybe more importantly than anything, it totally exonerates me.
Well, no, that is what you would call a lie. It has nothing to do with you. The report chastised former FBI Director James Comey's handling of the Hillary Clinton email investigation, and it concluded that Comey was not motivated by political bias, but apparently you didn't read that page.
You look at what happened. They were plotting against my election.
That would be something else that you would call a lie. Just read the report, sir. And when your friend from Fox News foolishly asked if they think James Comey's actions should result in jail time, you said this.
Certainly, they just seem like very criminal acts to me. What he did was criminal.
Another whopper. That's a lie. The report doesn't level any criminal charges against Comey, but you followed it up with this, Jim.
I think Comey was the ringleader of this whole, you know, den of thieves. It was a den of thieves.
That is a lie, too. Comey was held in very high regard by his top staff and by FBI employees. And this lie is also something else, an insult to the tens of thousands of people who work at the FBI, which is considered the premier law enforcement agency in the world. You also regularly trash Robert Mueller's investigation. Today you said it's totally discredited, which it is not. You regularly trash his team, and you don't pass up an opportunity to do so again today. You didn't. Watch.
13 angry lawyer. Democrats. They're 13, I call them 13 angry Democrats, and others worked for Obama for 8 years. I mean, you have no Republicans.
Another, guess what? Lie. Mueller himself is a Republican, as is Rod Rosenstein, who is overseeing Mueller's investigation. So what about your Singapore summit this week with the North Korean leader Kim Jong-un?
I signed an agreement where we get everything, everything, but they say Trump lost because he agreed to meet.
Well, no, that is a lie on a number of fronts. A lot of people, including your opponents, think that reaching out to Kim Jong-un was a positive move. Talking versus threatening, that's good. But many remain concerned that you're ready to give away the store to a murderous dictator. And when you say, we get everything, that is utter nonsense. All you got was a broad statement of intent to denuclearize the Korean Peninsula. North Korea has agreed to that before and never followed through since the 1990s. But you gave North Korea something it wanted. Suspension of military exercises with South Korea, a surprise to our friends in both South Korea and Japan, and a shock to the Pentagon. Then there's your immigration policy at the border.
If you notice, when I came over, they were all saying about separating the families, and that's a Democrat bill. That's Democrats wanting to do that.
That is another lie. It's your Attorney General, Jeff Sessions, who implemented a zero-tolerance policy and is aggressively prosecuting and separating parents and children if they enter the country illegally. You say you hate this, and you hate that it is happening, and that it's just the Democrats' fault. But you can stop the practice anytime you want. Only you can stop the practice right now as quickly as it can be stopped. You can do that. So what about Paul Manafort, your former campaign chairman, who is in jail tonight after his bail was revoked?
Manafort has nothing to do with our campaign. He worked for me, what, for 49 days or something? A very short period of time.
So that's another lie. Manafort was your campaign chairman and chief strategist. And he worked for you for 49 days? It's another lie. We did the math. He worked for your campaign for 144 days.